Meðlemið áhafnarinnar geta aðstofa ykkur með björgunarvesti fyrir börn.
Iceland, here we come.
Hey, no shameless plugs.
Welcome to Who Time in Iceland. As you know, as a true Whovian, Doctor Who is with you wherever you go. Much like my Sierra Leone video, which I'll put a link to up here, I'm going to show you all the wonderful landscapes of Iceland and tell you about the links between Doctor Who and Iceland. Looking at the broadcast history, in-show references, and fun facts. Now let's roll.
I want your clothes, your boots, and your snowmobile.
From cold Iceland. Well, this is the opera house behind me, flashing lights, it's pretty cool. Got some mountains over there. Yeah, so the broadcast history of Doctor Who. So as far as we can tell, classic Doctor Who wasn't really broadcast here. I know what you're thinking that's a terrible way to start off the video. Why on earth does this video exist? Well, it gets more interesting. So apparently a run of omnibus editions of Tom Baker serials were broadcast here at a NATO base in Keflavik in 1986. Very strange. After that, in the late 1980s, British satellite channels started being made available to Iceland, like Super Channel and BBC Prime, and they aired Doctor Who. Baby, you're small pussy, like you all know that. So, bizarrely, given that they didn't broadcast classic Doctor Who on an Icelandic TV channel here, for some reason they did have cinema screenings of Doctor Who and the Daleks, the Peter Cushing 60s movie, in June 1967 and in August 1968. And it was called this, I'll pop it up here, which translates as Doctor Who and the Robots. And it had Icelandic subtitles.
Enjoying the beautiful view!
Hello! About to go for a burger, but before that, new series. So, Iceland did in fact broadcast it, hooray, on their own channel called RUV, or RUV. I don't know how you say it, but it's here. So when the show came back in 2005 in the UK, Iceland did broadcast it, but a few years later. So series 1 got broadcast in 2007 here, and series 2 got broadcast in 2008. And then it stopped. On the TV listings, it was called Timmerflak, I'll put that here, which means time traveller in English. If you missed it on Icelandic TV, BBC had their own channel called BBC Prime or BBC Entertainment. Welcome to Black Beach. This is where volcanic lava has met the sea and created this. And it's black, it's mad. There's a cave there in the mist. And then over there, some stacks. So now I thought I would kick off the in-show references to Iceland quite aptly with this beach here. In the first Doctor story, The Keys of Marinus, Barbara Wright, first Doctor companion, compares the volcanic heating system on Marinus to the hot springs of Iceland. And that's in episode 4, The Snows of Terror. Welcome to Kerid, a volcanic crater that is extinct, so don't expect any explosions. So in the Out and Out classic, The Talons of Weng Chiang, the Doctor mentions that in the 51st century that Iceland is part of the Icelandic Alliance. It lost the war to the Supreme Alliance of the Eastern States and was occupied until the Filipino army liberated Reykjavik in the Battle of Reykjavik. So there's some interesting history, or should I say, future of Iceland, according to Doctor Who. Just a quick one. In the following story, Horror of Fang Rock, in 1900s, Ben Travers theorised that the fog that covered Fang Rock came from Iceland. Welcome to the cabin. Have a look around. Here's the kitchen, living room space. Yeah, well, it gets dark early here. You have about 6 hours daylight from about 11 to about 5 if you're lucky. So we're back now. It's a very short window of time to film stuff. Oh, fun fact time. Long after Eccleston had hung up his leather jacket as the Ninth Doctor, he appeared in the 2015 crime drama called Fortitude, which was shot in Iceland. He was a big fan of the Icelandic beers as well. Me too, for that matter. Right, now for some new series in-show references to Iceland. So apparently in the Bad Wolf Parting of the Ways two-parter, there was a reference in there, where apparently sometime prior to the year 200,100, in the Icelandic city of Pola Ventura, they hosted a reality TV show called The Murder Spree 20. Check out geothermal plant behind. Do you remember when the Icelandic banks went kaputsky? Well, this actually got mentioned in Doctor Who. Remember the Planet of the Dead Easter special of 2009? In that story, Lady Christina D'Souza told the 10th Doctor that the reason she became a thief was because her father lost a lot of money in that debacle. Check out Lava Field behind. Well, thanks for watching. If you want more references of Iceland in Doctor Who in the books, audio and comics, you can look at that on TARDIS Wiki. I'll put the link in the description below. Don't forget to subscribe and click the bell for notifications. Your support really helps the channel grow, so appreciate it. Don't forget also to like and to comment. Just a little game for you if you want to comment. Why don't you tell me about episodes where snow or Arctic landscapes are featured in Doctor Who? There's quite a few, I can name some. Ice Warriors, Bonal Snowmen, ooh, A Sign of the Daleks, Thin Ice. Yeah, just list them. It'll be fun. Until next time.